wanted to show you something I thought was gross. This is absolutely ridiculous. Red and blue, like the Pillars. Stupid Jimmy Fallon is in the Fallen Angels.
Tonight we'll be taking a look at the pros and cons of having a devil baby.
Yeah.
NBC's new miniseries Rosemary's Baby starts this Sunday, so we thought now would be the perfect time to re-examine this all-too-common issue. So let's take a look at the pros and cons of having a devil baby. Here we go. Pro, hearing the doctor say, it's a boy. Con, with horns. That's good.
It is a devil baby.
Pro, giving your baby a pacifier. Con, or as he calls it, a lucifier. Pro, posting pictures of your baby on Instagram. Con, noticing you can't use the remove red eye feature.
He's a devil baby.
He's a devil baby. He's got red eyes. Why would you want to take away what's him?
I know, I know. Pro, hearing baby say his first words, goo goo gaga. Con, hearing the neighbor's dog say, as you command, master.
That's weird.
That's not good. That's
he's a devil baby.
That's a big con.
Possessed.
He's a devil baby.
Pro, telling people my baby is the spawn of Satan, the prince of darkness, and the one true heir to all that is evil.
That's
con,
good.
Hearing other parents respond, yeah, mine too.
The devil wears diapers.
That's right. Pro, may have the mark of the beast. Con, or even worse, red hair.
Fearless.
The only reason we left that is because our head writer has red hair. That's why it's in the show tonight. There he is. You can even see your hair through the darkness. That's how look how pale he is. It's 80 Miles. He's currently starring in Revenge of the Nerds off Broadway. There he is, 80 Miles, everybody.
You're not.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't know that.
He just mixed up his facts.
I just mixed up my facts, sorry, dude.
Boy.
Yeah. Pro, getting a baby Bjorn. Con, returning it for a baby Beelzebub. That's not real. And finally, Pro, you can teach him how to play I've Got Your Nose. Con, he can teach you how to play I've Got Your Soul.
These people are sick, man. These people in the audience are sick. This stuff's not, it's not even funny. Not that the subject matter, not like I'm just because of the whole subject matter, just straight up, it's not even funny. It's a real dark place we're living in, you know? And that's the thing, man. Like, I'm not trying to make you believe in Jesus Christ or God or any of that stuff, because I can't force you to love someone or love something that just doesn't work that way. But what I'm just trying to do is just trying to show that there is an evil side to all this stuff, and, man, you don't want to pledge any allegiance to it. That's all I'm trying to do. You know, this is a world where X-Men is the number one movie in the world, you know, and that movie's director is under investigation for raping children. I mean, no joke. So I'm just trying to show this stuff because it's gross, and the world needs a spanking. And these people that are sitting out there encouraging this stuff, laughing in the studio audience there, they're going to get what they deserve, not what they expect. It's the truth. And speaking of that whole Pledge of Allegiance thing, just want to show it's to that thing right there. You know what this is from? This is from the brand new episode of The Walking Dead game that just came out on the Xbox. Well, it's actually not just the Xbox, PlayStation doesn't. They do different episodes, different installments of this Walking Dead game based off the zombie TV show. And this is the brand new episode that came out in May. And it's right there in front of your face. I mean, this stuff is everywhere. It's not coincidence. No one's reaching for anything. I mean, just grow up and just admit the fact that this damn cube, doorway, Stargate, Saturn, it's in everything. I mean, just grow up. I mean, you got to be completely in denial to not see this. That's the whole thing right there. That ring, really. You don't see that very often. All right. Thanks, teammates and subs.